just stalked this lovely little carp. Just come down a narrow arm of the lake. So I just come down with a little stalking rod, 10-pound power carp line. Just dropped a lead, very small little 1-ounce lead underneath a little bush down there. And about half hour later, this ripped off and this little baby, more than welcome on a lovely sunny morning. The swim's disturbed now, so we're gonna go back to our spot, get some more bait out, do some spodding, get some bait out. Me and Lee are gonna show you how we get our spodding, once we've found our spots, get our spodding done and get the bait out there. Happy days. Right, we're gonna talk a few tips on how we spod. Spodding's a great part of our fishing. It's really important to get the bait out onto an area. Me and Lee have been using it for years to great success, especially in the British Championships. Being able to get bait out at range comes with practice, and once you can do it, it's a real bonus for your carp fishing. So we're going to run you through a few of our tips and what spod mix we like to use, and then we'll show you how we use our spods and what we do with them.
Yeah, this spod mix we made up this morning, we've had fish over it as well. 10mm new grange. We've got a bit of Hinders ground bait in there, a mixture of pellet, a response pellet, mini combo pellet, and a bit of liquid. Sort of bind it up.
The ground bait binds it up, doesn't it?
Yeah, the ground bait binds it up.
And what we do today, we're going to use the spom. And what this does, this allows us to get the bait out without any spillage. It's a very clever device that once you get the bait, fill this area here. Once that's sealed, you can use this for spodding, and it doesn't leak any, don't get any spod spill whatsoever.
Extreme range, you know, isn't it?
Yeah, it flies really well, and then just as it hits the water, it pops open and it floats, skims across the surface when you retrieve. So it's a very fast method of getting a lot of bait out. And in the right hands, these fly a long way. I know Hutch has put one of these over 180 yards, so it's impressive.
They fly like a bomb.
Yeah, it's brilliant. Yeah.
Yeah, they're really good, aren't they?
Yeah. Another thing you're going to need if you're going to do spodding is a finger stool. It's a must. If you don't use a finger stool, you're going to cut your finger. Don't try and be hard. I've seen cuts on people's fingers and it will cut you down to the bone, so be careful. Make sure you use a finger stool.
Especially when your fingers are wet and soft through the mixture of ground bait. They cut really easy, don't they?
Yeah.
We've done it ourselves and we've learnt our lesson.
Yeah.
And every time now it's a finger stool for us.
Right, we're going to talk about spod mixes in itself. What makes a good spod mix and what makes a bad spod mix? What do you reckon, Lee?
Our spod mixes change, don't they?
Yeah.
Depending what water we're fishing. If you've got a lot of bream, we tend to shy away from the pellets
so much, and stuff,
and the particle. Big fish or bigger fish in the water.
More boilies.
It's mainly boilies, 14 mils.
Yeah.
We like to get them rummaging around, and we don't keep nothing. If we do put pellet in it, it's going to be all different sizes. Nothing's the same.
We put chop boilies as well.
Crumb.
Yeah.
From chop to whole boilies in, don't we? Yeah. You want it, but you don't want it too stiff, so it's coming out like a lump of putty. They feed out of curiosity a lot of the time.
Yeah.
They see something cloudy
and
they're on it straight away.
Yeah.
And you just don't want a big ball.
All them different size, the many different sizes gets them confident as they're picking up different size baits. When they actually come to your hook bait, there's a good chance that they're not going to be spooked off of it. So you get confident with the, like you say, you can see so many different size food items in there that they just get on that and they lose their inhibitions. And then when they do come across a larger boilie, they just take it. I see a lot of spod mixes that have loads and loads of sweet corn in it. Yes, carp love sweet corn and yes, they will eat it. But if you want to take quick, if you've got a bit of yellow as a sight pop, that's the colour they want to come in and see. So we tend to steer away from sweet corn and maize, don't we?
We put tuna in it, a lot of tuna, don't we? Yeah. A lot of fish. It's depending what water we're fishing, really.
Yeah.
And we do our background and our own work and see what the fish like.
Right, should we get some bait out in the water?
Yeah, let's get some bait out and get spodding, shall we?
Yeah. We first start off, we found our area out on the lake. We've got a marker float out there. This is our setup. It's a high-S spod rod. And basically we've got this braid, Power Plus, Power Braid, spod and marker braid. Very good for the job. With a 50-pound shock leader. We use a speed link and we can clip the spod on. But what we do first, to save casting out and putting bait where we don't want it, Lee's gonna just clip, he's clipped it up. So I'll just show you.
Just to get the distance, isn't it?
Just to get the distance. It'll cast the lead out to the marker float, and that way you can accurately hit the marker float and then hit the clip, and that's spot on the money. So we know that's done. And you can do this at any range, but it just means that you ain't casting two or three spots with bait in them and not reaching the spot, and then it's putting bait where you don't want it. So that's your first key, is to get that rod clipped up to the right spot. You can walk the lines out, but it's easier to do this way.
What we do, as Rob said, we remove the lead just to get a distance and just clip the spot on. Saves all that tying and cutting the leader. Just slip a towel rubber over it so it's not going to come off. And it's ready to fly. Go on then, get your hands dirty.
You can get in a rhythm and it's pretty quick. Good thing is, if there's two of you, it's one can get the mucky hands, the other one isn't getting it all over their rods and reels. Another tip, if you are on your own, have another bucket by your side with water in it and a towel, and just wash your hand off every time. This is quite a dry mix, but we have used really wet mixes that are really sort of stodgy and really sticky, so it can be really messy.
Tend to use the wetter mixes when the water's deeper, don't we?
Yeah.
So it gets down.
Yeah.
It hasn't, if it had 15 foot to get down,
yeah,
the dry mix would get lost in the layers. Where the wetter mix would go straight down when it's more heavier.
Yeah. It's on the money again. Once you get into a rhythm, isn't it? It's easy, isn't it?
Yeah. And you can put a lot of bait out quickly, can't you?
Yeah. What you don't want to do, you don't want a massive tight patch right all exactly on the same spot. You want to try and make an area. The reason being, if you've got a small patch out there, you're only going to get one or two fish feeding on it. But if you can make an area the size of perhaps a car, a small car out there, there's fish can come in and graze. If on the heavily stocked waters I'm talking about now, but they can come in and they can graze on the area, can't they? And we found that a bigger area, rather than putting it all in the size of a dustbin out there, which you can do, but it just, you're only going to get that one bite because there's only really a couple of fish on the area. Another tip, we set a mark on the bank, normally about a metre from the bank, and what you'll see Lee do is he'll stand on that mark all the time, but then other times
just go forward,
forward, and that will put the bait the other side of the marker, and that will give you a depth rather than all in a line, the bait in a line, and then step back a metre back into the swim and do the same again, and you end up with a square area rather than just a line of bait hitting the clip all the time and the line of bait stretching that way. You get the depth and you get an area, and that's where the fish can graze on.